Hey everyone, how we doing? My name is Tim Pongres and this is Focus on Detailing. Today's video is all about the foamiest of foams and one of the easiest ways to protect your car. This video will be revolving around AutoGlim's Polar series, a group of products that from start to finish help to create for a safer and more efficient way of making your car look amazing, from easier cleaning to protecting. What makes up this kit in order of application is first of all their Polar Blast. Used in a foam cannon or foam gun, it engulfs your car in a thick layer of foam, helping to emulsify the immediate mess, safely removing it. Next on the list we have Polar Wash, applied in the same fashion with a similar result, but this time, while the car is all nice, thick and foamied up, we're going to be using a wash mitt to glide over the surface to remove whatever grime and filth is left. Last on the list is Polar Seal, applied in the same fashion with the foam cannon to the now wet, clean car to protect it, creating a hydrophobic, high gloss finish, and is all set to close up this job, but not before drying. But trust me, once you have this on the car, drying is a breeze. I was also lucky enough to have AutoGlim's foam cannon on hand, a sturdy quality build, perfectly shaped for ease of use with the wide mouth so we avoid any spill of those precious liquids. Now, I think that's enough talking with the quick overview of each. It's time to get into actually using them.
The car I have with me to detail today is a 1999 Toyota Prado, and I was lucky enough to show it off and these products at this nice big depot. I'll be going over each step in detail, leaving my main thoughts till the end. I'll avoid talking about cleaning the wheels, as that's usually what would be done first, but not what this video is about. First things first is to make sure the surface is cool to the touch. It's really important for every step that you avoid straight sun and those hot days. Not much setup is needed. All that was done is filling up the foam cannon with a dilution ratio of 1 to 5 with Polar Blast. Don't go over the top. Do what's recommended and you'll be more than pleased. First up was the pre-wash stage. Starting from the bottom, I worked my way up to the top, covering the car in a thick layer of snowy-like foam. This initial step is to help create a safer wash by loosening the immediate mess, effectively dragging off the filth that could damage the paintwork in the later stages. This is all happening during the dwelling stage, waiting the recommended 10 minutes. You can see it's really foamy, almost like a shaving cream, and that's exactly what we're wanting. I used my brush during this time as well to clean in the tight spots like around the badges and door handles. Once I had my fix of watching it slide down the paintwork for 10 minutes, I rinsed it all off, leaving behind a surface that was all set for the next stage, which was using Polar Wash. With the now empty cannon, I mixed in Polar Wash to the desired amount. Hard to tell at this point what the desired amount was, as I don't know what the results could be, but they recommend no more than a ratio of 50 to 50. I wasn't far off since this is a bigger car and I obviously needed more. Polar Wash works in the exact same fashion, spraying from bottom to top, but this time, instead of dwelling, we immediately began working over the car with a wash mitt, using one bucket alone to rinse out the mitt every so often. This job would take over from the usual two bucket method, allowing for a more hands-on clean to remove whatever grime is left over the paintwork. Using that thick foam to have the mitt safely glide across the surface was a big bonus, having no need to dunk it back in the wash bucket, but it did create one thing that I needed to keep an eye on. I had to work relatively quickly, not only because this car is big and the foam was sliding down gradually, but because it was a warmer night as well. If you wanted to take your time a little more over your car, there is a way around this, and that's by simply foaming then washing the particular spot that you wanted to focus on, before moving on to the next. This is only an issue if there's a risk of the product drying, which you really want to avoid, but as long as you can clean up every spot and rinse it all off once you're content that it's clean, then you'll have no worries. The car was now cleaned right up and safely in no time at all. Looking better now, it's time to add some gloss and protection. Bring on Polar Seal. It's really important to not go over the top with this ratio, recommending 4 caps then at least 200ml of water. No added bonus by adding extra. As I spread it over the big beast, I avoided the windscreen, as like other protective products along these lines, they can smear once the wipers are in use. But everything else was all good for a nice covering. Immediately, you could see it doing its thing as it hit the surface. As stated before, having a concentrated mix isn't always better, as you can be left with larger clumps of the protective layer, pooling on the surface, potentially staining that spot with water spot-like appearances. Once everything was covered, I immediately rinsed it all off thoroughly, making sure to work over every spot. You can see just how well the beading action is going, repelling the water really well. And if it's doing this, you know that the final stage with drying is going to be a whole lot easier. As the towel glided across the surface, I could feel just how slick it was, easily picking up the water droplets as I worked over the entire car once more for the final time. A speedy process with the boosted protection. No need to wring out the towel or use more than one. This was the end result after running through the entire kit. It was looking and feeling amazing. It's a credit to the owner for how well it's been kept. An older car now, but still looks great. Only going to be staying this way if it's treated like this every so often. You can give the glass a good going over with a dedicated cleaner and cloth, but we're fine in this case as there's no droplets left. So back to Polar Blast, a nice smelling, safe washing liquid that foamed up incredibly well, clinging to the paint, helping to break down and remove light mess. It's stated to be pH neutral as well, so it won't be removing any existing protective layers. At around $45 for 2.5 liters, it's a fantastic buy and will last you plenty of washes as long as you follow the dilution ratio. Polar Wash was allowing for that deeper clean along with the mitt, doing a fantastic job of covering the car in foam again. I did have to work relatively quickly, but that's only because it was a larger car and plenty of spots to clean and reach into. It was easily rinsed off, leaving behind a gorgeous clean finish. pH neutral like Polar Blast, so no removal of waxes and sealants. At around $35 for 2.5 liters, it's well worth the money. Polar Seal was such an easy protective product to apply. Spray on, rinse off. Leaving behind a super slick finish, increasing the juiciness levels. They say with this, there's no need to apply it more than once a month. For $48 for 1 litre, very little is needed to get the job done. And a great job is what it does. A big tick for this one too. Just a quick note, it's important to also rinse out the cannon after each use, especially with Polar Seal, to avoid cross-contamination. Now, as long as you're working in a cool environment and have your pressure washer and foam cannon at the ready, then you'll be all set for this kit. On that positive note, I'll be closing up this video. Thank you all for watching. Don't forget to check out the socials, and I'll catch you all later.
Today's video is all about the foaminess of... Not a good start. Help to create a safer and more efficient... Let's just start again. A group of products that from start to finish help to create a more... Why is it that bit that I keep stuffing up? Safer and more efficient way. What makes up this kit in order of application is Polar Blast. What?
Your voice.
But I sound like that, don't I? Lastly, we have Polar Seal, applied in the same fashion as before, but this car, baby, I'm really struggling. You stuff up once, you stuff up the next time, it's just an ongoing. How was that? That was a little bit extra that I added on the fly, and it made it work.